My name is Stephanie Johnson, and I'm the first black female captain at Delta Airlines.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Welcome aboard Delta Flight 965. We'll be underway for Atlanta shortly. Thanks for joining us.
As captain at Delta Airlines, I am responsible for making sure that the flight operates safely. So I'm kind of the last line of defense. But the ultimate responsibility before we push off the gate is for me to make sure that everything has been taken care of and things are as they should be before the flight commences. And then if there are any emergencies or any problems during the flight, it's my job to manage that and to make sure that the right people are helping me make the right decision. I was very fortunate in always having a fascination for airplanes. So I chose the career to be a pilot when I was in high school, when I realized that maybe it was a possibility. I just always thought airplanes were neat. I thought, wow, how great to just get off the ground. And I had a teacher in high school that mentioned that he had an airplane. So I asked him about it after class, and he said if it was okay with my parents and I got a couple of friends, then he would be glad to take us on a flight. We went flying out of Burke Lake for an airport in Cleveland, Ohio, in a Piper Cherokee, and I got to sit up front. My friends were sitting in the back, and they were terrified because he actually let me fly the plane once we were airborne and showed me how to keep the wings level on the horizon. It feels great when I see people recognize that I'm the first in different things and first black female captain at Delta Airlines. It was a little bit tough at some points in my training to be the only woman in the class and the only African-American woman in the class, because after class, you know, you really learn a lot when you're interacting with your classmates. And I got along well with my classmates, but there was a little bit less of a camaraderie than they had between each other. You know, it was mostly white males that I was in classes with, and it was very rare to see a woman, let alone a black woman there. I think I saw any black women when I was in college. But it was something that I wanted to do so much, that almost didn't matter. You know, I mean, there was that little component to it, but it was this focus on just do what you're supposed to do, study and try to succeed and excel. STEM fields are critical for the future development of our country and of our world. Science, technology, engineering, mathematics, they're all fields that traditionally women have not gotten into, but as many people have seen the movie Hidden Figures, you know, it's not because of lack of brain power. It's perhaps lack of interest or lack of encouragement. And I want to encourage you right now, you know, any women out there, that if that's something you're interested in, that's something you can do, and you can do very well. Having a seat at the table to me means that you have done something that someone else may want to do, and it's your responsibility, it's my responsibility to share that and to be a voice and an ear for someone who wants to come behind me, because I need some folks coming behind me. I need some good co-pilots. I need some good captains once I retire to carry on the legacy. So having a seat at the table is very important, and I think all of us, particularly black women, we need to be out there in our communities, and we need to let other people, not just black young women, white young men, to show them that this world is inclusive of everybody, and there are great values no matter what a person looks like. Someone has something that they can offer you. So I think that's very important.